Hello friends, today we are going to create a 3D model with the help of 2D drawing sheet. We are starting with a very easy drawing sheet. While completing this drawing sheet, we will understand the concept of 2D and 3D, and along with this, we will learn the basics of the software. Here we can see that the three views are shown here in this sheet: front view, top view, and isometric view. All the dimensions are mentioned in millimeters. With the top view, we can get the outline dimension of the model. From this place to this place, we can think of a rectangular shape, and from here a tangent arc shape. So let us create a sketch up to this point by using mentioned dimensions. Here we can see our software is open. Start a new part file, click here. In this new SolidWorks document dialog box, click here to create a new part file. Our drawing sheet is in millimeters, so change the document's unit to millimeter gram second from here. Activate the sketch command. We can see that a new sketch can be drawn on highlighted three planes: front plane, top plane, and right plane. As per our requirement, select top plane to start a new sketch. From here, we can see the top plane is normal to our work window. Here are our several 2D drawing tools like line, circle, arc, rectangle, etc. Pick 3-point rectangle tool and draw a shape in the following way. The first point of the rectangle should be put over the part origin. This glyph shows that this point is vertically aligned with the part origin. Next, put the second point. This mark shows that the software has applied a vertical constraint automatically on this side of the rectangle. Next, put the third point. Select the middle point of this side of the rectangle and part origin together using the control key on your keyboard. Then apply a coincident relation between them. Now we will activate a sketch tool using the right-click menu. Activate the 3-point arc tool and draw an arc in the following way. We can check the software has automatically applied tangent relation between the arc and this side of the rectangle. The same relation is applied on the other side too. Convert this line into construction geometry. Using the Smart Dimension tool, apply dimension in the sketch which are mentioned in the drawing sheet. You can see, after applying the dimensions, the color of the sketch has changed to black, which means the sketch is fully constrained. This is what mentioned here on the status bar too. Exit from the sketching mode by clicking here. Set the view orientation of the model as isometric in the following way. So now we want to extrude this sketch. For this, we need the height dimension. To get this, we will examine our drawing sheet once again. In the front view, here is the dimension mentioned for the height, which is 30 mm. As we have got our dimension, activate the extrude boss oblique base command. First, select the sketch and then fill the depth value. Green check mark to apply the command. Save the file with the name Fixture Block. Now we will change the color of the part. Select the part from the Feature Manager design tree and activate Edit Appearance command. From Appearance Scene and Duckle tab, select Polished Bronze and apply a new color. Now we will change the lights of the file using Display Manager. Edit the ambient light of the model. In this input box, fill the value 0.8 and save and apply the changes. Let us get back to our drawing sheet. From this drawing sheet, we can see we need to create this type of shape. The dimensions to create this shape is mentioned here. This line is 9 mm away from the bottom and this line is 18 mm away from the center of the circle. So let us create the sketch on the basis of this dimensions. Activate the new sketch and draw a sketch on this face of the model. Set the view of the model normal to the front plane. Pick the corner rectangle tool and draw the sketch coincident with the two sides of the model. Apply the dimensions as mentioned in the drawing sheet. Add another diagonal line in the sketch and exit from the sketching mode. Click the previous view command to switch to isometric view. Activate extruded cut command and select the sketch. From the selected contours box, clear the selection. Now hover over the sketch and select both the contours. Now we need the dimensions of the depth of cut. So we switch back to our drawing sheet. We need to find the distance from here to here. So first we calculate the distance from here to here. The distance of this point to this point is 9 mm. And from this point to this point is 12 mm. Again, the distance of this point to this point is 9 mm. Now we add all the dimensions, the result will be 30 mm. From this distance, we will subtract the distance of this portion. The result will be 23 mm, which we will divide by 2, that is 11.5 mm. So in this way, we will use this dimension in the extruded cut dialog box. Fill this value and apply the command. Now we will use mirror feature to create the same type of cut on the other side. Activate mirror tool and first select front plane as mirror, face or plane from the feature manager design tree. Then select the cut feature as feature to mirror and execute the command. Open the visibility of sketch tool. We will reuse it. Again, activate the extrude cut tool and select the sketch. Select this segment of the sketch contours to use. In the direction field, select through all and execute the command. Hide the visibility of sketch 2. Now we will return to our drawing sheet to observe the final shape and get more dimensions. We need to cut this type of shape. The dimensions to create this shape is mentioned in the top view. We will use these two dimensions to create this shape. So let us create this shape. Select this face of the model and from the menu select sketch option. A new sketch will start on this face. Set the view of the model normal to the top plane. Draw a shape with the help of line tool. Apply dimensions using the smart dimension tool. In this dimension, we can put an equal sign and select the previous dimension to apply an equal relation between them. Draw two more lines and next create a center line coincident with the part origin. Put a check mark on these two places to draw a horizontal line of infinite length. Activate Mirror tool. Select the sketch. Next, select center line and apply the command. Exit from the sketching tool. With the help of this sketch and extruded cut tool, remove material from the solid. Start a new sketch on the top face of the model and draw a circle coincident with the part origin. The dimensions of the circle is mentioned in our drawing sheet. Here we can see this is mentioned. With this front view, we can understand the hole is through the model. After creating this sketch, create a hole in the model with the help of it and extruded cut tool. So now we can see our model is complete.